On Christmas Eve, 1968, astronaut Bill Anders snapped a photo of the Earth as Apollo 8 orbited the moon. Those three guys were surprised to see from their eyes our planet looked like an Earthrise. A blue orb hovering over the moon's gray horizon with deep oceans and silver skies. It was our world's first glance at itself, our first chance to see a shared reality, a declared stance and a commonality, a glimpse into our planet's mirror. And as threats drew nearer, our own urgency became clearer, as we realized that we hold nothing dearer than this floating body we all call home. We've known that we're caught in the throes of climatic changes. Some say we'll just go away, while some simply pray to survive another day. For it is the obscure, the oppressed, the poor, who when the disaster is declared done, still suffer more than anyone. Climate change is the single greatest challenge of our time. Of this, you're certainly aware. It's saddening, but I cannot spare you from knowing an inconvenient fact, because it's getting the facts straight that gets us to act and not to wait. So I tell you this not to scare you, but to prepare you, to dare you, to dream a different reality, where despite disparities, we all care to protect this world. This riddled blue marble, this little true marvel, to muster the verve and the nerve to protect this planet. You don't need to be a politician to make it your mission to conserve, to protect, to preserve that one and only planet that is ours, to use your unique power to give next generations the planet they deserve. We are demonstrating, creating, advocating. We heed this inconvenient truth because we need to be anything but lenient with the future of our youth. And while this is a training in sustaining the future of our planet, there is no rehearsal. The time is now, now, now. Because the reversal of harm and protection of a future so universal should be anything but controversial. So Earth, pale blue dot, we will fail you not. Just as we chose to go to the moon, we know it's never too soon to choose hope. We choose to do more than cope with climate change. We choose to end it. We refuse to lose. Together, we do this and more, not because it's very easy or nice, but because it is necessary. Because with every dawn, we carry the weight of the fate of the celestial body orbiting a star. And as heavy as that weight sounded, it doesn't hold us down, but it keeps us grounded, steady, ready, because an environmental movement of this size is simply another form of an Earthrise. To see it, close your eyes. Visualize that all of us leaders in this room, outside of these walls or in the halls, all of us change makers are in a spacecraft, floating like a silver raft in space, and we see the face of our planet anew. We relish the view. We witness its brown, green, and brilliant blue, which inspires us to ask deeply, holy, what can we do? Open your eyes. Know that the future of this wise planet lies right in sight, right in all of us. Trust this Earth uprising. All of us bring life to exciting solutions never tried before, for it is our hope that implores us at our uncompromising core to keep rising up for an Earth more than worth fighting for.